Death toll in Delhi riots rose to 42, even as people attempt to come to terms with the grim reality of the destruction and loss. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal announced in the meantime that on-the-spot ex gratia will be given to people whose houses were in fact burnt down. In the meantime, while Delhi attempts to pick up pieces, Mirror Now has accessed probe details that reveal alarming numbers. Out of 42 people who lost their lives, 17 lost their lives due to bullet injuries. 12,000 calls were made to police controlled room in those 4 days.
अभी तक हमने 123 FIR दर्ज कर चुके हैं और 630 के करीब जो है persons जहां तो arrest कर चुके हैं जहां detain कर चुके हैं वो सारे cases जितने हैं उसको हमने top priority पे लिया हुआ है. उसमें अलग से SIT जो की टीम है उसमें ऑफिसर्स डिप्यूट कर दिए गए हैं. जल्दी हम ब्रेक थ्रू मिलेगा और आपसे हम शेयर करेंगे.
Back now, Alok joins us with more details. Alok, if you can take us through the probe details at this point, how many FIRs have been registered? And most importantly, one of the biggest questions that is concerning at this point is how did people manage to get those weapons?
Yes, definitely, Amitabh. Before telling you about the details of investigation, I would just like to show you what's all happening at the DCP office. This is DCP office, Northeast Delhi. This is Seelampur, where Ajit Doval, who is NSA, had also came just to take, before he taking over the charge of the whole violence incident that happened in Northeast Delhi. I would like to show you because there is a victim help desk, is in fact set up at the DCP office, and it is just to give the aid to the victims and the NGOs which are coming forward to give any sort of help. Here you can see this is victim help center, this is set up, and these are the two officials who are sitting here. However, this is the morning time. As of now, the victims or the NGOs have not yet come, but what the police says, because it has set up today only, so police says that they have informed the public as well. They will keep coming, and whatever the help they need, because the violence had happened in various parts of East Northeast Delhi, that is related to various areas. So definitely the concerned police station, the concerned department has to be in fact informed what their belongings have been lost, whatever the things have happened to him, so they can write it in the letter and then they will forward it to the concerned department. This way the help will be given to the victims. So what the police has told us, that is why this victim help center has been set up. But apart from that, if you talk about the investigation angle, Delhi police is doing the investigation. Two member SIT has been formed. Their primary focus is, as of now, their primary focus is on three aspects. That first is those people who instigated the mob, whether it's Tahir Hussain or other BJP leaders, because remember, Kapil Mishra's name is also cropping up in this whole process and in this whole issue. So that is first aspect. The second aspect is the arms from where they got the arms, because remember, the Arms Act cases have also been registered. 25 arms have been recovered, 25 firearms have been recovered. So police is also working on that. And third aspect is the criminals, those local criminals whose involvement could be possible into this whole whole violence that happened in East Northeast Delhi. So local criminals aspect is also being investigated. Remember, one of the person who was identified as Shahrukh Khan, he is still absconding. His role, and in fact his video was come out when he was pointing out a pistol. Now police has found out that he has a previous criminal record. His father is also in the jail and his brother is also in the jail, and he is now absconding. So he has previous criminal record and he is a criminal background person. So definitely police is also working on this aspect. So these three aspects police is as of now working. But if we talk about the ground situation, for the past 48 hours, no report of violence has come out. But we hope that the peace will maintain and the normalcy will retain very soon.
All right, so no reports of violence in the last 24 hours, at least, like Alok was pointing out, and Alok was also pointing out how an SIT has now been formed. 42 people have lost their lives already.